My name is Cathy Myron. I'm CEO of eSilo, a data protection and cybersecurity company focused on small businesses. Today, I wanted to take you through a case study of something that we proposed to a photographer and videographer who had a lot of information to protect and was wondering what was the difference between redundancy and data backups. So this is what the photographer is doing today. He takes the memory card from his camera, inserts it into his PC, and then downloads his files to store them on a local storage device. And this is just a small NAS or network attached storage device that sits on his desk and contains lots of different hard drives to give him extra space beyond what his computer can store by itself. So because he has so much data, the first thing we wanted to do was put together a proposal around an on-site backup system. So basically a set of local backups that he could use to recover if something happens to his computer or to that network storage device. That's his first backup copy. And then secondly, to protect him against any disaster that might affect his home, like a fire or a ransomware or malware attack, we wanted to ensure that we were replicating those backup files to our cloud repository, giving him a second backup copy stored off-site. This is in line with the 3-2-1 rule, or the golden rule of data backups. And the golden rule says you want to have at least 3 copies of your data, the one you use every day, and at least 2 backups, and that all of those backups be stored on different types of storage media, whether that's an internal hard drive, an external USB drive, a file sharing repository, a cloud backup provider, or even a CD or DVD-ROM. And then the one in the 3-2-1 rule says that one of those backup copies should be stored off-site and off-network. And that ensures that if you do have a cyber attack or other incident, you've always got a pristine copy of your backups that you can recover from. So one of the questions that he had was, what's the difference between disk-level redundancy and a true data backup? Because he thought that having redundancy on the hard drives in his storage device was like having a backup. And the simple explanation is that it's not. So the purpose of redundancy is to ensure that if a hard drive fails in that array, that the remaining drives that are still functioning have enough information to recreate all of the data that was on the lost drive. Whereas a backup is guarding against the possibility that the entire storage array either becomes corrupted or unusable. And so it's taking a complete copy of all data on all disks and storing it in a second location. This is why when you have a lot of information, it's important to have both disk level redundancy in the way that you store the data, as well as a complete backup copy in the event that something happens. If you want to learn more about how to protect your information, I would invite you to schedule a one-on-one at meetcathy.com. Or join our social media groups on LinkedIn and Facebook, where we share helpful tech tips for business owners and individuals and answer any questions that you have. I hope to see you there soon.